Hey guys, what's up? I'm Rohit Khanna, host on Click Digest, and today we have with us the Vivo V11 Pro, which is the latest offering from Vivo, and we are going to unbox this. This phone comes in a price segment of under 30,000 rupees, and Vivo has been quite aggressive and quite popular in this space. And just like some of the previous phones, this one also comes with an in-display fingerprint scanner. So this is one of the Vivo's USPs, the fingerprint scanner that is under the glass. And this phone is also with the same technology. This is the fourth generation of under the glass fingerprint scanner that you are getting from Vivo. Some quick features are mentioned here on the box. It comes with in-display fingerprint scanner, full view 3.0 display, dual pixel rear camera, 6GB RAM, and this phone is coming at under 30,000 rupees, which is quite an impressive and aggressive pricing for this phone. So opening the box, the first thing that you get is a small paper box which comes with Vivo branding, and here you get some accessories which includes a soft silicon back case for the phone. You get some documentation, and there is also a SIM ejector tool. There are some stickers, and then there is the phone, and this is the Vivo V11 Pro. And as you can see, it comes with a beautiful curved back design. I'll keep the phone to the side for the moment and show you what else you get. Here you get a fast charger which comes with up to 18 watt of charging power, so 9 volt to ampere. You get good quality earpod style earphones. These are with Vivo branding. The headset also contains a microphone and a button to accept and reject calls, and this is how the tips of the earphones look like. These are the earpod style earphones. They look quite good in quality. And then you have a USB to micro USB charging cable that has been bundled. That's all in the box. Let me get rid of everything and get back to the phone. So this is how the V11 Pro looks like in skin, and let me give you a quick physical overview of the phone. The most impressive thing about this phone is this front display. This is a 6.41 inch display, and it is almost edge to edge. As you can see, there is a very small notch at front which comes with 25 megapixel front facing camera, and just above the camera there is a horizontal slot which is for the earpiece and some sensors. Below the display there is hardly any chin, so it is around 91.27% screen to body ratio. On the right hand side of the phone you would find power wake up key followed by the volume button, and this is nicely finished in a glossy metallic finish which looks very premium and upmarket. On the other side you get the SIM card tray. Let me quickly pop it out and show you the SIM configuration. So this is the SIM card tray. As you can see, it comes with two nano SIM card slots and one micro SD card slots. There is no hybrid card business going on here, which is a very good thing. On top of the phone you can find a secondary mic hole for noise cancellation. On the bottom of the phone there is charging port, primary mic, 3.5mm audio port, and a speaker grill. On the rear is the Vivo branding dual camera setup, which comes with a 12 plus 5 megapixel camera setup. The 12 megapixel sensor is a dual pixel autofocus camera which produces good results. I'll talk more about that in the camera section. There is Vivo branding and designed by Vivo branding here, and it comes with beautiful texture at the back which does look quite upmarket. Let me quickly set this up and get back. And we are back after quickly setting up this phone, and two things that we set up during the phone setup is the face unlock and the fingerprint scanner. And as you can see, the in-display fingerprint scanner, which is the fourth generation scanner on this phone, works like a charm. The face unlock also works beautifully. Let me just turn it towards my face and it unlocks. It hardly takes any time. It unlocks in the fraction of a few seconds. And with the Vivo V11 Pro, it gets an infrared based face recognition or face detection, which is really fast as well as works in the dark also. So no matter if you are in a well lit environment or in a dark room, just look at the display and it unlocks just like this. Let me demonstrate once again. As soon as I turn it towards my face, it unlocks within the fraction of seconds, which is amazingly fast. Before moving further, let me give you a quick camera test of this phone as well. This phone comes with a 12+5 megapixel camera setup at the rear. So let's find out how well does it click pictures, how well the rear camera works. It also comes with a lot of modes. If you observe here, it says photos, videos, face beauty, panorama, professional, dock. So you have plenty of modes you can choose from. When you are in photo mode, you can also enable this portrait, in which you have to keep some distance from the object. And when you take portraits, it blurs out the remaining part of the picture and keeps the subject in sharp focus. So this is our subject for this shot, and you can see that this is in sharp focus while rest of the objects are blurred out. There is also Google Lens support inbuilt in the native camera application, which is a great thing. You just hit here and it will start the Google Lens, so you have to be signed in to try that. But this is a great thing that it is supported natively, and this is how the 25 megapixel front facing camera looks like. It is quite wide and it is capturing a lot of details here. You also have live photo here, you have face beauty, selfie lighting. So there are plenty of modes. When you are using selfie lighting, you can control how the lighting looks like. You can also use the loop light, rainbow light, monochrome background, etc. So let's take a normal selfie just to compare. And here you have a front facing shot. This one is with monochrome background. If you observe closely, everything in the background is now black and white compared to the other picture where the background objects are colored. Here the background objects, so you can see this red car in the background, and with this monochrome lighting, this background is now monochrome. So it really makes you pop out and stand out in terms of shot. You also have the artificial intelligence selfie or AI selfie. So there are a lot of features that are available. AI beautify selfie. So you have plenty of features when it comes to taking pictures with this phone. The cameras are really top notch. I'm putting on some samples on your screen that have been clicked with this camera, just for your comparison and just for your assessment of this camera. Now let's talk about performance. This phone is paired with a Snapdragon 660 octa-core chipset, which comes with artificial intelligence features. There is 6GB of RAM and 64GB of ROM. It comes with a large 3400 mAh battery, and it has a dual engine fast charging, which charges it very fast compared to any regular smartphone. In terms of software, it runs Android FunTouch OS on top of Android Oreo, and is quite a breeze. It's quite easy to use as well. As you can see, the UI is also fairly responsive and the phone feels very slick and very smart. The display here pops out. This saturation levels of this AMOLED display are pretty good. So I'm overall very impressed with the Vivo V11 Pro. What are your thoughts? Do let us know in the comment section below. Give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed watching this video. Stay subscribed for more. Press the bell icon. This is your host Rohit Khurana signing off. Thanks for watching.